When time comes, then comes this place. But with humility comes wisdom. Sometimes we go through some seasons or some periods in life that are meant to teach us the applicability of the scripture, of the Bible, into our lives, or in another way, God trying to communicate to us that we are moving away from God and telling us, hey, yo, you are forgetting my existence in your life and you're going in your own way. Come back to the right path. Hello there. Welcome to this channel. If you are new here, my name is Dorothy Museo. If you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. And a big thank you to you for all being here today. Have you ever gone through a season or a phase in life where you felt like everything is moving according to your plan, or everything is just falling in place effortlessly? You don't have to put any effort, but everything is just going according to your favor. At that moment, success for you sounds like second nature. And in one way or the other, subconsciously, you start convincing yourself it's because of your brilliance that you are a genius, that everything falls in place for you. I have ever been through a such phase in my life. I recently came across a video on YouTube by the Wajizas family, where they were doing a video anticipating the pregnancy of their third one. And in that video, they had some high hopes and expectations that it's going to turn out positive, but it turned out negative. And Kabi made a statement that really resonated with a part or a season in my life that really taught me big lessons about humility, gratitude, and patience.
And it too, sorry, like, it's like I got proud. Like, I was like, it's obvious. Like, that's why I was even trying to calculate the time and where we will be. Like, hata nishasema mtoto atazaliwa.
You know, it is so much easy when we see everything falling according to our plans or according to our expectations. We tend to forget the role of divine grace and the presence of God and this role in our lives. At those moments, we tend to focus on ourselves and we believe that the achievements that we are actually seeing are basically due to our own efforts or due to our own hard work or because we are just brilliant or genius. The particular season in my life was the period that we were anticipating for our undergraduate graduation, and it was like around 2 months to the graduation and we had received all the results except just one unit. And at this moment, I really envisioned how my graduation was going to be. We had our clothes ready, rechecked and resized when necessary. The clothes were ready and set for almost everyone in my family. And so I really believed and I was confident that even for this one unit that was remaining, I'm just going to pass it like the others. And yeah, what was remaining was just for the date to come and we march up to the graduation square and celebrate like, yo, I'm graduating. About 1 month to the graduation, the final result was released, and my friend called me and told me, hey, you can check your photos, they have released the final results. And I was so happy, though with a bit of anxiety, but I was still much more confident to look at the photos. And I'm telling you, yo, I was met with a crushing blow to my soul and my spirit. I had actually failed. I got a supplementary, meaning that I was not going to appear, or implying that it's almost impossible to graduate in September or with the others in the first graduation. So the only thing that was remaining was for me to wait for the supplementary exams to be scheduled, which meant they are only scheduled after the graduation has happened. And if at all I pass in the supplementary exam, then I have to wait to be in the next graduation list, which was 3 months, 3 or 4 months later on. So for weeks, I was sinking deeper and deeper into dark clouds of negative thoughts of how much of a failure I am, how much I'm not capable, And like, I had a lot of negative self-talk and a lot of negativity going out when I went through my mind. And it was even made worse when I got into the WhatsApp group and I could see all the people were mocking us because we had failed almost 3/4 of the class. It really struck deep within me of how much of a failure I am, because I'm missing the graduation and I was really confident that nothing was really going to stand between me and this graduation. But yes, here I am. But yes, I had to accept the fact that I have to wait until they graduate and we have to wait for the supplementary exams and for the results of the supplementary exam to see if we at all we qualify for the next graduation. For the moments that I was falling deeper and deeper into darkness of negativity, I was met with a light of realization that I had grown so much proud of myself. I had grown so much self-centered and so much confident about myself, feeling that I can control the world around me. I can actually do anything that I want. And this was really making me get proud within myself. And I was actually forgetting to acknowledge the source of my blessings, the source of why all this has been happening. I had seen people getting supplementaries right from first year, but here I'd come from first year to fourth year until the last result was remaining, and I had actually grown so much from I had not realized all these blessings that had happened in my life. It was like a wake-up call for me, a moment of realization, the fact that I had grown so much proud of myself and so ungrateful, taking God's blessings for granted, and I was slowly and slowly moving away from God's presence, because at that moment I can attest to the fact that I did not really feel like God was anywhere related to my studies. Yes, I would go to church and meet God there, but I was not thinking like God is anywhere related to my studies. But here comes a moment that I'm feeling like it's God telling me that, yo, you've grown so much proud of yourself and you need to humble down. From that experience, I intentionally started on a journey of cultivating an art of gratitude and humility, both to God's will in my life and to the people around me. As the Bible says in 1 Peter 5:5, and let me read, all of you, clothe yourselves with humility towards one another, because God opposes the proud, but shows favor to the humble. It's actually really easy when we don't show humility to those around us to then easily show humility to God. It was actually a journey that I started to appreciate every blessing and every setback that I meet along the way as a source of an opportunity for me to grow, both physically and spiritually. For this period that I had to wait for 3 months before the next graduation, I actually learned in the biggest and almost hard way about patience and surrendering to God's will, even at moments that we feel His will is not aligned according to our own will. The Bible time and again reminds us of the importance of gratitude, humility, and trusting in God's plans for our lives. As you can see in Proverbs 11:12, when pride comes, then comes disgrace. But with humility comes wisdom. So that reminds us to always be humble in everything. And in 1 Thessalonians 5:18, we are encouraged to give thanks in all circumstances, knowing that God's faithfulness endures forever. So even when we are facing those moments that we are feeling everything is just going according to how we would like it to be and according to our expectations, we should never forget to be grateful and give thanks to God at those moments. We should not just wait for the dark moments to come when we remember, oh, God exists, and that is when we are running to Him for help and for assistance. As we navigate through life's ups and downs, let us always remember to cultivate hearts of gratitude, humility, and trust in God's will and plans for our lives. So let us not forget to acknowledge His goodness and grace in our lives, both in happy moments and in dark moments. If you have watched this video up to this far, I'm sending you all my love, my prayers, and a heart overflowing with gratitude and a spirit filled with humility. Until next time, take care and God bless. Dorothy Museo, signing out. Bye.